The information from this vet appointment also gave us the ability to start planning into Atsa's future.
I hear the wind call your name. It calls me back home again.
Since the appointment, Atsa has grown even stronger and even bolder. He trots around sound and engages with his environment, looking at new objects with curiosity rather than fear. At Steph K Equestrian, we have lots of experience working with unhandled horses, including wild Mustangs. We have successfully rehabilitated and retrained several wild Mustangs, including ones without any handling experience and ones with a variety of handling experience that led to severe aggression and behavioral problems. However, Atsa was certainly an extreme case. Due to the degree of starvation when Atsa first arrived, we had to be careful about the refeeding process. Initially, we had to restrict his access to certain calorie and nutrient-rich foods as his body adjusted. These calorie and nutrient-rich foods are very high value and motivating when used in training. During this time of restriction, these foods were even higher value to Atsa, and so he began to take food by hand. And despite being conflicted and nervous around people, he was reluctantly willing to participate in training. As Atsa's condition improved, we were able to gradually increase his access to these high-calorie foods. Although this was the ideal thing for Atsa's physical and mental health, it meant he would no longer take feed by hand and was significantly less motivated to participate in training with people. After working with Atsa for several months, understanding his life history, and reviewing the vet's findings, it was clear that Atsa did not have any future as a domesticated horse. Despite being healthy and strong, Atsa is still in his late 20s and is already in a situation where he is a good candidate for retirement. Pushing him to become domesticated and tolerate human handling would be traumatic and inhumane. At best, it would require confinement, isolation, and restriction from food in order to coerce him into cooperation with positive reinforcement methods. At worst, it would require excessive force, restraint, and ingraining of deep learned helplessness. It didn't have to be this way. If Atsa had not suffered such severe trauma at the hands of people, he may have been open to life as a domesticated horse. Horses like Mustangs are not born terrified. They're actually born rather bold and curious. It gets them into all sorts of problems when they start venturing into campsites or residential neighborhoods. Domesticated equine life is also vastly different than that of the wild. They have different food, different routines, different amounts of space, and different amounts of freedom. These Mustangs have their entire lives turned upside down. They are often not given adequate time to adjust to their new situations and are typically handled and trained using aversive and force-based methods. So it's understandable that they would be fearful and traumatized after this experience. Unfortunately for Atsa, his trauma seems deeper than that of most other captured Mustangs. This could have something to do with his age, size, or the specific environmental history that he encountered during capture. And it's likely some combination of all of those and even more factors that we don't realize or haven't acknowledged. Regardless of the reasons why Atsa is the way he is, it's clear that the best and only feasible option for his future is retirement, ideally at a large sanctuary situation where he has access to friends, forage, and freedom, and the ability to fulfill his needs naturally, like he did for decades while he was wild. Steph K Equestrian makes a commitment to do right by every equine that enters our program, meaning that Atsa has a safe forever home here if needed. That said, this likely isn't the ideal happy ending for Atsa. He deserves more space than we can provide him, and there are always going to be people at close proximity here, meaning he will always have some level of stress. Luckily, Atsa has another, better option available to him. We've received confirmation that Atsa has a space waiting for him at one of the best sanctuaries in the United States. His sanctuary placement is in the same region as his original homeland, meaning he will be able to return to his natural climate and roam thousands of acres alongside other Mustangs. Even better, the sanctuary is already home to other rescued Mustangs from Atsa's original herd and family groups. This means that he'll be able to see his family again. Atsa deserves to live out the rest of his life, wild and free, with dignity, alongside his friends and family. the only thing standing in his way is a 2,000-mile trailer ride. And we need your help to make that happen.
I can't stand the distance. I can't dream alone. I can't wait to see you, 'cause I'm on.